A double-decker bus transformed from diesel to 100% electric is being tested in Auckland this week. The conversion, completed in a Masterton workshop, is a Southern Hemisphere first. And as Laura James reports, it could see our public transport meet emissions targets ahead of time.
The wheels on this bus going round and round, once powered by diesel, but no longer.
These are the big ticket items, so that's your charging point. These black boxes here, they're the batteries. We can charge this bus in probably about 45 minutes.
The double-decker was 3 years old when Transit decided to give it a makeover.
This is the first sort of repower that's been done in the world. I know they're doing one in the UK at the moment. For us to get this up and going during COVID and our guys to do it in Masterton was a pretty good feat, to be fair.
We like to think of it as a big Lego set that's been reconfigured.
The bus lives in Wellington, where it's already been serving commuters.
The bus would leave the depot about 5:30 in the morning, come back to the depot maybe at 1, 2 o'clock for an hour-long charge, and then go out to maybe midnight, thereabouts. So 24-hour operation, effectively.
This week, it's being tested on our biggest city's routes, a long journey to get here.
So if you compare the trip that we were to do on a diesel bus of the same size, we've saved a tonne of carbon. I think we spent about $200 charging, and diesel cost for this bus to get up here would be about $1,200.
Transit's plan now is to convert all 20 of Auckland's double-decker buses in the next 2 years. Once they've got the green light, they'll be able to pump one out every 2 weeks.
The 20 are just those operated by Transit. In total, Auckland has 200 double-deckers, all running on diesel, and many of them relatively new.
The reason this bus is here is because we are very interested and we are committed to transition the entire fleet to zero emissions. We anticipated we would have commercially viable double-decker electric bus from 2025 onwards, and here we are, we already have example. It just has to prove that it can deliver.
We'd love to start tomorrow, to be fair. We've been waiting and we're geared up with the expertise and knowledge to make it happen.
A conversion costs just over $400,000.
Which makes it competitive to building a new one. And the big advantage here is that we're actually pulling a diesel off the road.
Hoping to make diesels history well ahead of the government's target to decarbonise the network by 2035. Laura James, One News.